Hello, and welcome to Weil McLean's series of tech tip videos. I'm Brian, and today we will be discussing our AquaBalance boiler and the system circulator wiring. The AquaBalance line of boilers has the capacity to power one circulator on the heat side from the control module. So we have produced a relay kit to provide power for a system circulator. The kit will make it easy to add a system pump rather than purchasing a relay panel. Keep in mind, this video is meant as a supplement to the instructions that come with the kit, along with the information in the manual. So you will want to familiarize yourself with all of those documents. To add the kit to the boiler, start by making sure the unit is unplugged and remove the front panel. Then, remove the screw that secures the control module in place. Next, remove the ignition wire, but be sure to grab the connector and not the wire. Now, we'll remove the module for better access. Next, remove the terminal blocks from the back of the module. The block with the two black wires will not be used, so we will secure this block to adjacent wires to keep it out of the way. Now, we need to release the three tabs to open the module and plug connection A into the control. Next, disconnect the wire connector between the control module and the incoming power supply. We'll use connection C and D to reconnect line voltage. Then, remove the front right ground terminal from the block, connect the B terminal to the grounding block, and reconnect the other ground wire to this terminal. Now, we need to install the existing terminal block and the new connection E to the back of the module. Then, connect the wires from the system pump to the open side of the terminal block. Reinstall the control module on the tabs and reconnect the ignition cable. Secure the module with one screw and reinstall the jacket door. Now, we need to make sure the circulator is configured as the system pump. And we do this by changing parameter B13 from 7 to 4. Just hold the top buttons for 10 seconds. Navigate to B13 and change the value. Hold the top buttons for 10 seconds and the unit is ready to test. Keep in mind, there is an inline fuse which is rated at 3.15 amps. If at some time in the future the system pump is not receiving power, this would be the first place to check. Remember, we always recommend after any type of service or repair that the system be completely tested to ensure proper operation. Well, thanks for watching. I hope this information has been helpful to you, and be sure to keep an eye out for new videos so we can help you keep your customers happy.